Okay, hello everyone and welcome back. SoupaSoka, once again playing on Kronos, the private vanilla world of Warcraft server. And we are super level 30 dwarf priest. So I want to check the mail real fast, and I want to mention one thing. So this guy, Chastity Keat, sent me a bunch of gold, it's been about 3 weeks. I went ahead and looted that gold out of there, it was like 150 gold or so, and I sent it to my warrior, so I don't want that gold to interfere with my leveling experience for this character, because it's just, basically, I'm worried that it would cause this character to be too easy. I would just easily have a mount, all these things. I don't really want to do that. So I sent the gold away. But otherwise, not much to report in here. There is a recipe here. We're going to go ahead and learn a gray woolen cloth, or gray woolen robe, which isn't super useful, but still something, and it's a little low level for us now, but still I think we can get some skill ups from it maybe later. I'm also going to disenchant this Tear of Grief I've been carrying around forever. I decided I never use it for anything, and it ends up just being kind of a waste. This guy here wanted a free enchant. I had some extra mats, so I figured I would help him out. I basically was advertising, but I wanted to get a free shield enchant, and I have tons of these lesser mystic essences and everything, so went ahead and decided I would give him an enchant, so easy enough, as long as he accepts it. Anyway, easy, no problem. So if you don't remember last time, we're actually in Theramore Island right now, so we're on Kalimdor. We came over here from the wetlands, and we're working on this missing diplomat quest. So we need to go find Private Hendel and Duskwallow Marsh, Dustwallow Marsh. I always say it wrong, I always say Dusk with a K, it's Dust with a T. So I'm trying to correct myself on that, and the guy's not too far away, so we're going to go find him now. I am not totally sure if we can complete this quest. I think it might be too high level, but I want to give it a try. And I also know that once we finish this quest, I don't know exactly where we're going to go, but I do know I want to get ready for Gnomeregan today. And getting ready for Gnomeregan actually isn't that hard. We already have this Gyro-Drill-Matic Excavators quest. We got that in Stormwind from Shoni the Silent, I think. Yeah, Shoni, there he is. He's in like the northwest, kind of the northern part of Stormwind. The rest of the quests for the Alliance in Gnomeregan are pretty much entirely, almost entirely, in Ironforge. And in Ironforge, they are over in the Gnome District. I call it the Gnome District. I guess it's Tinkertown is the actual name. And there's like 5 quests there, and they're all stacked together, so you don't have to go anywhere else. You grab them all there. Actually, there is one more quest in Kuranos, so that's the small town south of Ironforge. So we will have to run down there to grab a quest also. And the quest down there, we can actually start, it's a chain quest, the one in Kuranos. We can complete that first part of that quest by ourselves, and I think we will try to do that today. We're also going to turn in Morla Dim today. We still have that quest from last time, we never did turn it in. And we have our hearth still set in Darkshire, so we can just hearth back to Darkshire, turn in the quest there, and be on our way. So, we're gonna try and complete this missing diplomat quest solo if we can. And then we're gonna go to Ironforge, turn in that quest, go grab all the Gnomeregan quests, work on the Kuranos quest for Gnomeregan, and then we'll be ready for Gnomeregan for next time. And I think we'll be able to find a group pretty easily for Gnomeregan. I know a lot of people in my guild are around the right level for that. I think we have, I mean, right now we have quite a few people between like 23 and 34, so depending on how quickly they're leveling, it's entirely possible they'll be ready next time. Who is this guy? Swamp Eye Jarl? Let's see what he has for us. I don't know what this... I've done this quest, I don't remember what it is. Let's take a look, at least talk to him and see what he's got for us. Bring 3 soothing spices to Swamp Eye Jarl. Okay, well, that's an easy quest. We just need to get some soothing spices. I don't think we can buy those back in Theramore, but I know we can buy them at any major city as a cooking trainer, so we can always go pick that up and then have this ready for if we ever return to Dustwallow. Gather Rot Blossoms. I'm going to abandon this quest. This is from Duskwood, which we won't be completing, I'm pretty sure. So let's go ahead and abandon that. Throw the Rot Blossom out of our bag there. And the Totem of Infliction, I don't think we're going to complete that either. We'll hold on to it for the moment. Anyway, we're closing in on our friend here. What's his name again? Private Hendel. Moving in on him slowly. If I remember right, he's like a 35 or 34, maybe higher. I think he's like 34 or 35, and he's got like 2 34 35 guards with him. We might have to try this fight a few times. If we get a good fear, I think we can complete this. I think that's what we mainly need, is to fear, get a fear that lands on all three of them and lasts the full duration, then we'll have a pretty good shot of being able to complete this. And I do have a Scarlet Gauntlet. I also got that in the gift from the guy that sent me like all the gold. I guess I'll just sell this on the auction house. I think they're worth a little bit. Don't really know exactly what I'll do with them just yet. So this guy's actually outside a little keep here. Let's see if we can get over there. There he is. You can see him in the distance here. Well, can't quite. There he is. Now you can see him. He's in this little camp. So Private Hendel's 35 and his guards are 36 and 35. I think there is a way to solo pull this guy. I'm going to zoom in a little bit so we don't get caught by the trees so much with our camera. Let's complete the quest. Okay, that's 850 experience. So defeat Private Hendel. How far away can we get from this guy? Where do we want to run? I'm thinking if we can aggro just him somehow and lose the guards, that would be really good. So let's pop Powered Shield. And I was trying to get Powered Shield up before a fight because the Weakened Soul debuff means you can't recast it right away. Powered Shield actually lasts longer than the debuff. So if you wait to engage someone until the Weakened Soul debuff is gone, you can recast Powered Shield pretty much right away. Okay, he resisted our dot. I'm going to try and dot him again. He resisted. I'm going to keep dotting him. Okay, we got him there. Can we outrun the rest of these guys? Okay, good. We can solo pull them. That's really helpful. Let's try and fear him. Good. Okay, this is perfect. Whoops, he did resist that. He did break that fear really quickly. But I'm feeling pretty good about this fight now. We can kill a 35 solo. It's 35 and 236s that make things a little bit trickier for us. Let's throw a heal on ourselves. And let's just keep... We're just going to wand him and dot him down. That's all we're going to do. I don't think anything else is necessary for this fight. So as long as our Shadowward Pain stays up. He's resisting though quite a lot. There we go. And we get Shadow Vulnerability, so that'll do a little more damage. But it's looking pretty good for us. We can pop another Powered Shield if we wanted to. I'm just gonna let our mana regen as much as possible. And that's definitely the way to handle this fight, is to pull him solo away from the other two. And once you do that, he runs back. Because you don't actually kill him. Let's make sure these guys are no longer aggressive, so that's good. But, oh, okay. We've got a little thing going on here. We got Archmage Tervosh, Pained, and Lady Jaina Proudmoore. That's some chat going down here in the text box. So. Ooh, they just took that guy and made him vanish. Like, straight up, he's just gone. Okay, we're gonna complete the quest. We got 2900 experience. Let's talk to Jaina and complete the quest. Okay, cool. Whoa, that was some sick experience there. We just leveled up. So we seriously just gained, from the turning the first part, we got 850 experience plus 2900. So that's about 3750 plus 5750. Yeah, that's a ton of experience. Wow, that's awesome. Okay, so that's a quick level 31 for us. We're going to throw some more talents into Shadow Spec, of course, or into the Shadow Tree. And let's get Shadow Weaving some more. So this will actually increase the chance to 40%. That's great. So it doubles the chance for that to proc. And the ring is 7 stamina, 3 strength, which... the strength doesn't mean anything to us. Basically, we could give up 7 spirit and 1 intellect for 7 stamina. I don't really think it's a great trade, so... I think it's the end of that quest line. And there's some other quest here. We can't pick it up yet because we're too low level. Okay. Well, I think that was the end of that quest line, I think. Unless there's another quest from Archmage Tervosh there. But I get the feeling that was the end of it, considering we got that reward from Jaina there. Shadow Magic is now a gray quest to us. We're going to go ahead and abandon that. And we got that all the way back in Red Ridge Mountains. It's quite a few episodes ago now. I don't know, maybe 10 episodes ago? It seems like it was quite a while. That's gone. And I think we've done our business here. Did I grab the flight point at Theramore? I think we already have the flight point, so I'm just going to go ahead and hearth from here. We can disenchant that. I'll put those gloves up there so I don't accidentally disenchant those. But yeah, so we're going to hearth to Darkshire. We're going to turn in our quest, the Morla Dim quest. I think that's here. And while we're here, let's go ahead and disenchant that ring. The Jaina Signet ring is cool, but not super useful for us. Is 31 high enough for cemetery? Well met. Okay, Morla Dim, let's complete this quest. Speak with Watcher Sarah Lattimore in Darkshire. Okay. So let's talk to Watcher Lattimore. Need help? Okay, complete take Sarah Lattimore's ring to Morgan Latimer's grave. Okay. Boy, yeah, his grave's way over here. I mean, these quests... they certainly want to run us around in circles here as much as possible in Darkshire. Someone commented on one of my videos and told me that to them, Darkshire and Duskwood is more of a zone that you maybe come to do a quest or two, and then leave after you get a level, and then come back a few levels later and do some more quests. And I sort of agree with that now. Originally I wasn't sure if that was the case. When I was first here, I didn't feel that was true, but just from what the comment was, and I started thinking about it, and it does feel that way. You know, when we came to Duskwood, it was quite a few levels ago, but there's still quests here we could even do if we wanted to. Like, Totem of Affliction's still green, and some of these quests, like the Morla Dim quest, there's no way we could have done that unless we had help from someone. If we didn't have help from someone, or just a lot, you know, a group of five people, there was no way we're gonna be able to complete that quest. Which, I mean, it's an elite quest. It's very common for elite quests to not be something you can solo. But yeah. Anyway, if you want me as DPS or healer for SM Graveyard, send an invite. It's possible we'll go run SM Graveyard now. Just because someone in the guild happened to ask for it. 31, I think, is okay for Graveyard. A little low. 32 might be ideal, but I think it's doable. Graveyard's a pretty easy instance. Want me to heal or DPS? Whoa, what's going on here? Do I heal this guy or do I let him go? Let's give him a heal. Looking like he's about to die, so I'm gonna keep him alive. I think he's gonna lose that fight, and I don't want our buddy to die there. Everybody gets one. Well, saved an alliance guy. That was kind of fun. I really wanted to let them fight it out, but once I realized our guy was gonna die, I'm pretty sure our guy was gonna lose that fight. I thought it was time. Oh man, I tried to shield him. I didn't realize shield didn't work on him. I always forget that you can't powered shield people that aren't in your party. I instinctively, when someone's low on health, will throw a shield, thinking it's gonna help them, and all that shield did was shield myself, so I almost lost that guy anyway. Huh. So we need a tank and one DPS. Okay, do I have the flight point up to South Shore? Pretty sure I do. I hope so. If not, we do have a warlock here who could maybe summon me, which would be really nice, but we'll see. We're gonna turn in this quest here, and then I guess we're gonna run to Stormwind, and you know, I remember this is exactly what happened. I mean, this isn't exactly what happened. Last time we were in Duskwood, I said I was going to speed up the video, and because I was just running through Duskwood, and I forgot to speed it up. So if we go back to one of my videos, I don't even know, I never really rewatched that part, but people told me that I apparently forgot to speed it up, and I'm guessing I tend to talk to myself sometimes. Like, I'm so used to talking. I'm basically talking to myself right now, right? I'm recording this, speaking in a microphone, and then uploading this later to YouTube. So I now unfortunately have this habit when I'm playing WoW to just talk to myself. Like, I will randomly just narrate things. So it's unfortunately often that I find myself just like playing on my warrior and I just start talking to myself, like what I just start narrating what I want to do. And then like a minute or two into it, I realize I'm not recording, I'm just talking to myself. I feel pretty dumb and stop. So I think I did that a little bit, possibly last time running through Duskwood, but that's okay. Anyway, so my point is, this time, running through Duskwood, I don't think I'm going to do that. I'm going to try and remember to either fast forward it if I do fast forward, or just keep narrating. So, we're going to kind of just cut through the graveyard here. It's a little faster, but it's a little more dangerous. I don't think we're not going to die or anything like that, but looking for one tank and one DPS for SM... Graveyard. I guess we might also do library, but I don't think I have time, let alone I'm not sure if my priest is high enough level to heal, especially because I'm not healing spec'd. I mean, if you look at my skills, like the only thing I have spec'd into that's going to be helpful is spirit tap sometimes and improved psychic scream a little bit. Oh wait, where's Morladim? Okay, we're running like right through the center of this pack, which is probably really stupid. Considering I can't actually fear these guys. You can't really fear undead. But okay, slowing poison. Can I stone form? Yeah. I just mouse clicked it. Don't get on me for that, guys. So someone commented on another video and reminded me that I have stone form, which I consistently forget that I have. So now I remember. I'll try to remember to use that. It's just very useful. You might as well use it if I can. Ooh, where's the grave? There it is. A weathered grave. Okay. You'll receive Archaeus, two-handed sword. We can't use it, but that's a cool sword, I bet. Let's take a look at what it looks like. It looks alright. That's kind of a cool sword. We're gonna disenchant it. We can't do anything else with it. I mean, we can sell it, but like, soulbound. So yeah. We're just gonna, it's not even that great of a disenchant, unfortunately. And this is the book that went with it. We can get rid of that, I think. Let's go ahead and buff that Pally. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to head up to Stormwind Orange Soda. I don't know if we click this. Nothing. Wait. Vessel of Rebirth. Okay, that's what I thought. Just spoofed. Looking for one tank and one DPS for SM Graveyard. Please send tell. Let's see if we get anyone. So what we want to do is head up to... Isn't Hogger down here somewhere? I'm getting distracted. I just realized Hogger is somewhere down here in Elwyn. I forget where. That's one thing. Eventually, it's going to take a long time. Someday, I'm going to hit 60 with this character. I think I'll go back through with him. And obviously, I'd like to do some high-end raiding. A lot of things like that. But I think it'd also be fun to go back through and explore some of the quests we maybe missed out on. Which includes, like, you know, killing Hogger and silly things like that. Like, just for fun, I'll have some videos like that, I think. But it's going to be, at the rate I level, unfortunately, probably like a few months away before I hit 60. I don't know if I can do live, or rather if I have time. So maybe we won't do it. Let's just see if they're okay with that or not. Either way, we're going to stick to our plan in that case of just going to get Gnomeregan started. Get the Gnomeregan quests ready to go. And yeah. I'm glad I'm Shadow Spec'd. I can't imagine leveling Holy Spec'd. I know some people do it, and they're like truly patient people to be able to do that, but I just cannot do it. I just don't know how you can do it. It just seems so slow. Even a Shadow Priest, I feel like it's relatively slow leveling. I mean, it's very consistent. Like, we have great regen, but man, I don't know what you do as Holy Spec. I guess spam Holy Fire and Wand? Shadow or Pain and Wand? I don't know. So it's been... one thing to, as a side note, the Kronos servers have been much more stable recently. I don't know if they... I know they switched to Kronos 2, but I think also Kronos 1 now to new hardware. And I've had very little lag, like almost no lag. I've had... let's dot this guy. Or dot this girl. I've had almost no lag. I've had really no disconnects for hours now. Like, I've played for several hours straight on different days over the course of several days of playing and haven't had any disconnect problems. So I think we're in the clear. So if you've been watching this play, I guess it's a Let's Play. If you've been watching this series and you have been on the fence about actually jumping into Kronos because you've been worried about it disconnecting or having lag problems, those concerns seem to be no longer the case. They just seem better. I don't really feel like we have these problems anymore, which is great. And I think the DDoSing, they say that they're constantly being DDoSed, but it seems to be under control as far as not causing problems, which is really nice. Let's talk in World Chat again, looking for one tank and one DPS for SM Graveyard. Tank and or DPS for SM Graveyard. See if we can find someone. And there's no quest for the Alliance in... I think there's only one quest for the Alliance. There's two quests. Mythology of the Titans, which is in the library. It's a book you pick up. And the other one is... what's it called? In the Light, or in the Name of the Light, or in the Name of the Light, something like that. That quest is actually... quest, you only need to go into Cathedral, Armory, and maybe Library? Definitely Cathedral and Army, maybe Library also. But if we're going to Graveyard, it doesn't really matter. Like, there's nothing in Graveyard that we need for those quests, so I'm not worried about grabbing those quests just yet. I'd be happy to do Graveyard because it has... The final boss in the Graveyard is Blood Mage Thalnos. And Blood Mage Thalnos drops... And we do have the South Shore Flight Path, which is nice. Blood Mage Thalnos drops an awesome item. I'll tell you about it in just a minute. We're going to fast forward for the flight from Stormwind to Ironforge. So we landed in Ironforge, obviously, and what are we... Yeah, okay, we need to go down to the Gnomeregan. I guess, either way, this Tinkertown is, I guess, what it's called, not Gnomeregan. So we're trying to go over to Tinkertown over here. And what we need is to get all these quests. Basically, you can see, because of the quest they add on, there's tons of quests here. We're gonna go grab as many of those as we can. And there's really, there's like... four quests there, one in Stormwind, which I think we already have that one. As I mentioned earlier, that's the Gyrodromatic Excavators. And then we're going to get these four, and then we're going to go to Kronos and try to grab the one over there, which we can start working on ahead of time. And then I'll explain why we're going to work on that ahead of time in just a little bit. So find Bingles. That guy's in Loch Madon. We don't need that quest. The day after. Speak with Ozzy Toggavolt in Kronos. Okay, that should be one. This is the leader of the gnomes here. This is a king of the gnomes. High Tinker Mechatork. The Grand Betrayal. So this is venturing to Gnomeregan, kill Mechaginir Thermoplug. It's the final boss there. We definitely want to do that quest if we can. Bring a Prismatic Punch Card to Master Mechanic Cast Pipe. That quest's kind of complicated. It sometimes, people often don't complete it, and I'll explain that also when we get into Gnomeregan next time. 12 artificial, Essential Artificials. Those are pretty easy to get. Not super easy, but definitely doable. So I think that's it for quests from here. Then we need to go down to Kronos to get our other quest. So I think that's it, right? Getting prepped for it now. Yeah, I think that's what we need. Is that it? I'm trying to decide if there's something else we're missing. I have, you know, actually, so I have a really nice, someone else made this. A very nice spreadsheet that someone linked me a long time ago. It's like a vanilla dungeons quest spreadsheet. It shows you all the quests you can get in vanilla WoW for each dungeon and where to get them and what they reward you with and everything like that. So let's see, what am I missing? Data rescue. Where is that? We got data. I'm looking at my list right now, just before we head out. Save Tink. I want to go back there real quick. I feel like I missed the quest. I'm not totally sure. There's one called Save Techbot's Brain, which you can do outside of the instance. And I feel like we should be able to get it, but I'm not totally clear why we didn't have it offered to us. So I'm going to go back in here and make sure we didn't miss it before we head any farther away, because I don't want to have to run all the way back here if I can help it. Huh. Oh no, there is a quest that we're missing. Okay, so to get this quest, We need to go to back to Stormwind, apparently. Huh. Okay, well that's confusing. So there's a quest in Stormwind we have to pick up. It's not that good of a reward, if I remember right. Like, I don't know if it's really that important to complete. So what I want to do is I want to link in the description below the video the link to the spreadsheet that I'm talking about. It's extremely handy. And I think it's definitely worthwhile. The only thing you get from the quest is experience and a little bit of silver. And some reputation with the Gnomeregan Exile, so I don't think I really care to go all the way back to Stormwind to grab that. Hopefully whoever we're grouped with will have it for us. Looking for tank and DPS for SM Graveyard. Okay, I'm talking in World Chat again, see if we can find someone for this other group we're trying to run. Who is this guy? I have a 37 hunter. If you want. Let's invite this guy. Click. Invited. Okay. Now we just need a tank. Let's see if we can find a tank. Any tanks for SM Graveyard? Okay, so we just need a tank now for our SM Graveyard group, but in the meantime, I still want to head down to Karanos and work on stuff. The one nice thing, no quests for SM Graveyard for Alliance. Sadly, there's no quests. I don't know why. You know, it's kind of a bummer there's not more quests for the Alliance in Scarlet Monastery. And it sort of makes sense, because Scarlet Monastery is a little more located. I mean, it's clearly more located. That should be okay for SM Graveyard. A 32 tank should be okay for SM Graveyard. We'll see. Invite Estrella. Okay. Well, let's see in a group already. Huh. I think I'm still going to head down to Karanos, because we have people in Badlands, Stormwind, Alterac. I'm hoping maybe we can get a summon from them. But if not, no big deal. I can always run up there, but what I want to do is actually go down to Karanos and set my hearth down here. So next time, if we're waiting for... Okay, there we go. Let's invite Estrella. Estrella? Yeah. Oh, it's 32 Paladin tank, not a Warrior tank. Should still be okay. Estrella, you'll tank. Hopefully this will work out okay. Alright, I'm gonna go turn in this quest here. I'll head over, but I'm in Karana, so it'll be a bit, unfortunately. I keep forgetting to put on my furbolg suit. I gotta do that. Oh yeah, this stupid quest we're turning in here the day after. It's actually in this little hut to the side. Yes, yeah, over here to the side. So let's talk to this guy. Ozzy Togglebolt, complete quest. So use the empties. This is no gain. It's based off of Rogaine, is what the Rogaine is a product. I don't know if it's a worldwide available, like available worldwide. But Rogaine is a product in the U.S. For men. And actually, I think there's a female for women's version of Rogaine now. Which basically grows your hair back if you start losing hair for certain people, for certain conditions causing you to lose your hair anyway. But this is actually a... What is it called? Based off of that. It's basically a spoof. So no gain, spoof off that. To complete this, the first part is you need to collect this fallout, which you can actually collect the fallout... what is it? The Trogs outside of the instance you can do this. But because there's so many people... Or because they're... We already got a group, basically. Since we already got a group for SM, I don't want to go do that just yet. I meant to set my hearth to Karanos. I'll just set it to Ironforge. Close enough. Thanks. I'll copy the link and check it later. So I recently added an add-on called URL Copy. If you use URL Copy... You can left-click on links, and then it'll pop up a little text box here, which will be highlighted for you, and you can use Control plus C to copy it. which is really nice because you can then paste it later in your browser or anything like that. Okay, so everyone, please head over. I'll heal, Estrella will tank, arrest our DPS. Let's not rely on the Warlock, but if he gets there with two others, we will summon the remainder. Yeah, so I don't want to have everyone just rely on the Warlock. It's one thing, it's kind of unfortunate sometimes, you get a Warlock in the group, people just assume the Warlock will get there, and two other people will get there and summon you, and it's nice that when people do that, but it's, it's nice when a Warlock will summon people, but it's a little frustrating. Are you in defensive or something? I don't know. Or a debuff? Oh, you're a mage. Never mind. I thought he might have been in defensive stance. Can't be in defensive stance because he's a mage. That doesn't make any sense. So we're gonna go to SM Graveyard today, I think, and that'll be kind of fun. It's a short instance, really short. I think 20 minutes, maybe 30, if we're slow. But it has a really nice a really nice drop from Blood Mage Thalnos at the end. He actually has a couple good drops. He drops a nice shoulder piece. And he drops a nice, what would it be, an offhand, I think, held an offhand item. Both are really good, I think for priests even, so that's nice. And since our group, let's start flying up South Shore. Since our group is a paladin, a hunter, a warlock, and a paladin, I think the paladins won't roll on it since they're cloth gear, the shoulders. I can see it. I mean, honestly, I can sort of see it, but I'm just not sure. The Warlock might roll on the offhand, because the Warlock could use it for sure. At least I think so. Someone else is whispering me. Okay, so we're flying up there now. It's going to be a pretty long flight. What I want to do is later I will link in the description an Excel file. It's like a Google document, actually. That you don't have to download it, you can just access it online. You can also save an offline copy if you want. On my way now also. And the Excel file is organized extremely well. There's tabs, and each tab will take you to a different instance. So, and they're organized from low level instance to high level. And each tab will tell you all of the quests available for that instance, grouped as alliance quests or horde quests, or neutral quests in some cases. It'll tell you where the quest starts, where the quest ends, what you have to do to complete the quest. I'm not sure about that last part. It tells you what you have to do, but it tells you the reward at least. So it's an extremely handy spreadsheet, and I found it on the Nostalrius forums maybe half a year ago or more, and I bookmarked it, and it's been around ever since. I've been using it ever since then. Sometimes I forget to refer to it, or I just don't care for certain instances and let it go and don't always grab everything. But like for Black Fathom Deeps, when we ran that a little while ago, I didn't complete all the quests. There was a really nice wand that I could have gotten that I missed. I think it was because Black Fathom Deeps we kind of did out of the blue. I just wasn't planning on running it, and then I got an invite and decided to go, which means I didn't have time to prep for it. But in this case, since we have the time to prepare, it's nice to get everything ready for Gnomeregan. So we have almost everything ready to go. The only thing we're missing is a Stormwind quest. Got a text from someone. If you've ever used a Bunsen burner before, if you've taken like a high school chemistry class or college level classes, you've possibly used a Bunsen burner. And a Bunsen burner, if you don't know what it is basically, it's like there's a rubber hose attached to it, or a plastic hose of some sort that you plug into a gas valve in your lab. And when you open up the gas valve, gas of course like will transfer through the hose that you've attached to this metal apparatus. And the metal piece basically sticks straight up, looks kind of like a metal candle, and gas will shoot out the top of it and of the Bunsen burner basically, and then you will light that gas. If you take like a match to it or something, the gas will ignite, and you have this like constant and consistent flame. And you can adjust the sort of the size of the flame, which with a little valve that you turn on the Bunsen burner, which allows more or less gas to come through. Of course, if you have more gas coming through, the flame gets larger. If you have less gas coming through, the flame gets smaller. And a friend of mine was asking what you call the thing you use to light the Bunsen burner. Because I've never used a match to light a Bunsen burner. What we usually use, and I don't exactly know what it's called, I'm forgetting suddenly. I call it a torch sometimes, or a flint. What's it called? A flint starter? Is that what I would call it? A flint lighter, that's what I would call it. I'm completely forgetting the name of it, but it's basically a piece of, like a spring-loaded piece of metal you hold in your hand, with, I guess, a piece of flint on the end, I'm not sure, but something causes sparks, and when you push against it, it causes a lot of friction and causes sparks to appear, and if you hold it over the flame, when those sparks appear, it'll light the flame. So that's, a friend of mine was texting me and asking me what you call those things, and honestly, I'm forgetting what they're called, I really am. I want to call it like a flint lighter, but I don't think it's the technical term. Well, I hope you enjoyed the story about the Bunsen burner and the flint lighter. If you guys know what it's called, send me a message, because I just cannot recall. We have a quest to turn in down here? South Shore. Oh yeah, we do have a quest to turn in down here. I forgot we've been holding on this quest for a long time. Let's go ahead and turn it in, and then we're going to run up to... I want to get the flight path. There's a flight path in Western Plaguelands. Chillwind Camp is what it's called. I want to turn in, get the flight path there. Let's complete the South Shore quest. Okay, recover 5, bring 5 recovered tomes. Okay, well, we're not gonna work on that quest for a while. It's like, so someone in guild chat saying world chat is so bad, and I'm saying it's kind of like Baron's chat version 1.5. It's sort of like an evolved Baron's chat. It's a little bit better, has some use, but it's pretty awful also. Let's see, there's our warlock friend. Mind if I run to Western Plaguelands to get the flight path? It's a little faster if you just run straight through Alterac and kind of cut through, but getting the flight path in Western Plaguelands is really convenient. It isn't much slower. So I want to run over there and grab it if I can. The one problem with Western Plaguelands, oh, there's a 37 undead warlock. I'm gonna turn over this way. It's sort of dangerous because you're running through Western Plaguelands, a lot of high levels up there. But if you go up there, you also get the flight path, which is really nice. You'll use it eventually, and honestly, when I go to Scarlet Monastery, I generally will use that flight path. To me, it's quicker. Like, if you just fly up there, you cut all the distance running through through Hillsbridge Foothills. So that's nice. And then, let's fear that Yeti. Get him out of our hair. Was it 31 Yeti? Yeah. Maybe it's a little dangerous. I'll just follow the warlock. I don't know. I really do want to get this flight path, but it is a dangerous route. And then once you get up here, so the Chillwind camp is right here. You still have to run along this edge here, and it's a little dangerous. On my warrior, I can do it. My warrior is... Whoops. I'm like getting stuck in this little hill down here, or this divot. My warrior is so well geared that when I put him in like defensive stance, which in defensive stance for a warrior automatically reduces all damage taken by 10%, I can put him in defensive stance and give him a shield. And just like for reference, the shield that my warrior has more armor than my priest has combined. So the shield alone has more armor. So my warrior can run through Western Plaguelands. He can actually get attacked by level 50 plus mobs. And they hit hard, for sure, but I can, you know, tank one or two of them as I'm running through. As long as I don't get chain dazed, I won't die. Whereas my priest, I think, would die in like two or three hits. So we've got unfortunately, our hunter friend down here. He's got Aspect of Cheetah, so he's fast, but he's also got Res Sickness, so that's no good. Our warlock is taking all the aggro. I would shield him, but I don't want to pull the aggro onto me. If he needed the shield, I'd give it to him, but I think he's fine. He only has 1,000 health, really. How does a 34 warlock have 10% less health than a 31 priest? That sort of surprises me. I guess at this point, just a little bit of gear can make a significant difference. Like if he's missing a head slot or something, or doesn't have a necklace, because like our necklace adds, you know, 10 health, for example. So this is SM Graveyards we're going to run. An SM Graveyard... Or Scarlet Monastery Graveyard is... So, I'll explain the whole instance. Scarlet Monastery, there's four wings to Scarlet Monastery, right? And these four wings are actually one instance, but they're completely separated. So if you clear all four wings and then zone back into the first one will still be cleared. It's not like you're resetting into a fresh instance every time. However, it basically, the four wings are nice because you can start running Scarlet Monastery at like level 30, and you can run it through like level 40, because each wing is probably like a 3-level range. So probably Graveyard is probably like 30 to 33, 31 to 34 maybe. Whereas, let's go this way. So it's library, or it's graveyard, library, armory, and cathedral. Those are the four instances within, or four wings of Scarlet Monastery. And that's the order of them as far as lowest level to highest level. Graveyard can be ran from about 30 to 33. Library is like 32 to 35. Armory is like 34 to 37 maybe. And then cathedral is like 36 to 40 range, maybe 35 to 39. I tanked. I was the main tank in Cathedral, which is the highest instance, as level 37, and our group did awesome. Like, even as 37 tank, no one died. We didn't have any problems. We cleared it quickly. I'd say it really maxed out at level 39 is probably the upper end for Scarlet Monastery as far as what you really need. I think once you hit 40, you're probably better off finding other instances or other places to go. Where's everyone else? Actually, the whole group did really make a lot of movement. Pilgrim's already up there. What are these things? Grandpa, Nancy, Vicious. Who are these people? These guys aggro this group of, I guess, Alliance? I don't even know if those are... it's not Alliance, of course not. I guess they're just NPCs. I just aggroed some random named NPCs out of that house there, and I've never seen them before, so I don't really know what their business was. Now, if I remember right, there is a way to sneak over the Undercity through this side, and I'll show you guys today how to do that. You know, a part of me always fears this is like some sort of bannable exploit type of thing, because to me, I don't know if it's totally safe going through here. Oh, as far as like, if it's a bannable offense, I don't think it is. I'm pretty confident it's not. I've heard a lot of people do it. It was a solid chest back there. I would not... Oh yeah, that chest back there is actually for a quest, so... is that the right way? Yeah, so there's a named mob in that building back there, which we might go to in a few levels. We need to be like level 36 maybe to worry about that quest. I can solo any horde. Anyway, and in that house, there's a named mob. You kill him, you collect his head for a quest from South Shore. But next to him is also a chest, and the chest starts another quest for you. I don't even think we're high enough level to do that quest. Like, even if we went in there and grabbed the item out of the chest, I don't think we could start the quest that's associated with it right away. So this is the Ruins of Lordaeron. This is right outside of Undercity, and now we're basically... This is the wall of Undercity here, and we can see on the map now we're actually in Undercity, sort of. Not really in Undercity, but near Undercity. Anyway, you can actually just run up this stupid wall. Just, like, face towards it and just keep jumping and running forward, and you can just walk right up it. So this is, like, classic wall jumping type of stuff, which is kind of fun. Although, I maybe just got stuck here. I appear to be stuck. Can I go up this side? Oh, wait, no, I can... Nope. Nope, made it out. Okay, you can walk up that other side the same way that I walked up. Never mind, got out. Hope our warlock doesn't get stuck, that would suck. So hopefully these guys make it. Okay, our warlock made it, that's all that matters. There's already one of us up there, so we can all get up there, no problem. So we're at this kind of backside of Undercity here. It's kind of fun just exploring this route through here. And there is a way up here. Maybe I need to go up this side. This hill is a little steep, but you can get up here. And there we go, snuck around. We lost our hunter, he's doomed. Never gonna see him again unless we summon him. Okay, see in the distance that Zeppelin? I think that Zeppelin is leaving Undercity. I hope it's leaving, because if it's arriving, try to turn around and jump back up the way you came if you get stuck. Otherwise, we can summon you. Alright, let's shield up. Does powered shield absorb fall damage? I guess not. You fall and lose. No, okay, it doesn't. That's interesting. Good to know. Didn't know that. It makes sense, but I wasn't really sure about that. There's Pilgrim. Okay. Cool. Looks like we're all good to go. And our hunter friend is still stuck. That poor guy. I'm really glad our warlock didn't get stuck. That would have been the worst possible thing. Just hang tight. We can summon soon. If our warlock had gotten stuck and he had a hearth back to wherever his hearth was, that would have sucked so bad. Now, though, we can summon our buddy here, Estrella the Hunter. And this group, by the way, like, it's interesting because our warrior and our warrior and our healer, I'm the healer, 31. Our warrior, or our tank is 32. Kind of low level. Like, a 32 tank's fine. A 31 priest as a healer is a little low, but, like, we can make it do. It helps we have a 37, a 34, and a 34. Like, those are relatively high level for graveyard, especially a 37 is very high. A 37 could run... I would be totally fine having a 37 hunter in my Scarlet Monastery Cathedral group. Like, 37 is totally acceptable. So this is really kind of a high-level hunter for us, which is totally cool, because, like, that's good, makes it easier. Let's summon now. Where are you guys going? Okay, you guys know what you're doing? They seem to know what they're doing. And these are guildies of mine. Let's see. Pilgrim, what is it? Guladam? Guladam? Whenever our warlock summons, I will click. Anyway, so we've got, you know, a couple guildies with us. These other guys, I don't think they're in guilds at all, which is cool. No problem with that. Let's go ahead and buff up our Voidwalker there, Sargron. Now, the hunter is still stuck. I don't know if he's actually still actively trying to escape or if he just gave up. Estrella needs to summon. Okay, so we just need two summons real quick. So let's do it. Let's summon right here. This is a good spot. I usually like to summon kind of down the path here. Goal, are you there? Wait, no shards? Hold on. Okay, let's get some shards. I didn't realize he had no shards. Okay, thankfully, he can farm shards here. I was running Scarlet Monastery on my warrior, and we had a warlock with us who got here, and realized he was too high level. He couldn't even farm any of these mobs for shards. He was like a 43, and he was looking for some specific item he wanted to get out of Scarlet Monastery. So he couldn't even get any shards from, like, any of the mobs, and then everyone in our group ended up having to run here. The problem was that everyone thought the warlock could summon, but he ended up not being able to, which was the problem. A lot of people weren't running because they thought they were going to get a summon. So that complicated things a bit. Okay, summons incoming, I think. Maybe. You know, I still forgot to set my hearth to Ironforge. That's okay. Darkshire's not that far away. That actually gives us a good excuse next time to go to Stormwind on the way up and grab the last quest for Techbot's Brain. Since Darkshire is south of Stormwind, so we'll go to Stormwind, then go from Stormwind up to Ironforge, and then run Gnomeregan next time, hopefully. Did everyone get this summon? Did Az get it? Seemed like he didn't accept it. Well, let's... You have up to 2 minutes after a summon ends to accept it, so hopefully he will accept it. I'm the group leader, so we got group loot going. Azriel, are you there? Oh, crap. Well, we're all about to die. I'm just going to hide up here as far away as I can. Well, I think I'm alive up here. I don't think that mage is going to, like, chase after me. Okay. Well, a 40 plus undead mage is here now. So, let's try that summon again. Once we get regrouped. Oh crap. Oh crap. Does he see me? I'm just gonna sit so he can't see me. Oh, he's almost there now. Oh, he did get free. I have no idea what route you took, by the way. I have no idea how we get to that side of Undercity. Did he, like, jump out and swim around or something? I'm not really sure what he did. Now, I can res our dead friend down there, but I don't know if it's... Where is his corpse? You know, they're all gonna die. I'm just gonna hide up a hill nearby while you guys get wrecked. Okay, I can res Pilgrim in a moment. Okay, where is Pilgrim's corpse? He's just like, just, there he is, right? I just hovered over him. Okay, we're gonna see how this works. I'm gonna go for the res. I'm probably gonna regret this, because I'm pretty sure something there is gonna kill me. Where's my res button, by the way? I haven't actually rezzed anyone in a long time. Let's go over here and let's see. Is he in line of sight? Okay. Rez incoming on Pilgrim. I need to make a macro that says who I'm rezzing when I cast rez. Like, you just say, like, cast rez on target, you know, and then in slash party chat mention, you know, rezzing percent T or something. Okay. Graveyard is on the left. Okay, shielding myself up. So there's four entrances here. You can see there's an entrance on the left, entrance on the far right, and these two locked doors. So the left one is graveyard, lowest level. The far right entrance is library, and the two locked doors are cathedral and armory. I think armory is the right door and cathedral is the left door. Okay. Let's buff up everyone. Buffs. Do I have water, by the way? I have 15 water. Good. Pretty good. I don't think we need summon in here. Can't summon inside an instance. I think that's everyone, right? No, we're missing someone still. Buffs. Everyone's good and buffed. Buffed. What are we looking at here? There's some torturing going on. And who... no, we can't go out... Need another to go out to summon. I don't want to zone out until I know someone else is here, because I think Estrella said he's AFK, so Pilgrim's the only other one that can help. So let's hope we didn't just zone out until, like, certain death. Huh. Okay, I guess we're gonna go. I forgot I put up my heal bar here. Let's cast some shields on that guy, little heal. I'm just gonna fear these both. They're getting a little bit scary for me. Like, it's just, they're just doing a little bit too much damage to us. And I don't really want them to kill us, so let's keep another heal on our warlock. If I didn't get, if I wasn't getting stunned, this would be a little bit easier. Shield that guy. I think we're okay. Who's got aggro? Okay. Well, we're running away, I guess. That works too. Why did we run away? I mean, I felt like we could have handled this mob. But... let's go ahead and fear. And let's Shadow Word Pain. What Shadow Word Pain is this? Rank 4? Do I have rank 5 now? Think I do? Nope, just rank 4. Okay. Shield this guy up. Okay. And I think we're all about good here. Can we just zone in? Can we zone in now? I mean, our guy's here. We don't really need anything else here. The only reason we were here, I think, was to summon the guy that's here now. So, let's get out of here. Although, we did get 2 greens from our recipe, at least, and a belt, so let's get in. Nope. You can't, you don't get summoned inside the instance. You can't summon inside the instance. Okay. Alright, well, I think we're ready to go now. I'm going to rebuff this, and Ezreal needs power at 4. Okay. So, let's get ready to start this up. Let's get our Furbolg suit on. What do I have? Retribution aura, devotion aura. Can I get blessing of mana? Or whatever the thing is that gives me mana. I forget what it's called. Blessing of wisdom? Is that it? Okay. Okay. Pull away. Alright. Go, go, go. Let's do it, guys. Blessing of wisdom. Yeah, that's what I wanted. 20 mana every 5 seconds. That's nice. Super handy. And I guess this is a good time to put on my healing gloves? Healing belt, healing hands. Yeah, that takes away a lot of our... We lose about 13 spirit and 10 intellect. That's quite a lot of mana and regen lost, but... Pilgrim... Wait. Estrella, are you here? Okay. So our warrior's AFK, our tank's AFK in just a moment, which is fine. As long as I know what's going on, I'm comfortable. Like, I don't mind delays, as long as it's not just silence. The worst thing to me is when you're in a group and no one says anything, and no one's pulling, and nothing's happening. But if someone needs an AFK, it's totally fine. You know, AFKs are very, you know, acceptable things. People need a moment to step away for something. I understand that. I guess I'm going to get rid of our questy tracking there. We don't need to track anything. Oh. Okay. Who's tanking his bear? Yeah, looks like the bear's tanking for the moment. All I did was throw a renew on the bear, which was pretty much enough. And let's go ahead. Oh, it's actually Beer the Bear. His name is Beer, like the alcohol. Cool. I was like, oh, his name's Bear. I usually call everything Bear if it's Bear. I call Furbolgs Bears sometimes. I'll call Druid Tanks Bears for sure. Let's go ahead and kill this one and CC that one. I'm marking because I guess I can. I don't know. Doesn't really matter, I guess. I went ahead and killed that rat because I could. This room's kind of cool. So this is a torture room, I guess, and it's not cool, but it's interesting, I'll say. This is like a torture room. You're gonna see some characters, like, chained up, and it's kind of creepy looking. Let's go ahead and cast some heals on our big guy here. And, yeah, it's sort of creepy, but it's interesting for sure. And I'll show you some of the, is a glitch in here. It's really funny to me. I think it's funny. I don't know, maybe it's not funny. I think it's funny. Let's see, Fade is Shadow, right? Okay, we got rank 3 Fade. Okay, we're good. I just want to make sure all of our stuff is ready to go. This Mage looks a lot like, this Warlock looks a lot like my Mage back when I had a Mage previously on Nostarius. And, oh, someone mentioned me that they requested that I don't talk about Nostarius as much because I, you know, Nostarius is gone. Totally true. So there's really no point. Oh, let's go ahead and actually heal this guy, I guess, real fast because he needs some heals. It's very true, Nostalrius is gone. Uh-oh, this is gonna be close. We gotta lay on hands there, I think. I wanna do a fear there. Do I still have line of sight on our tank? Yeah, I do. Okay, I lost our tank for a moment there. Anyway, so... Someone commented that, you know, Nostalrius is gone, which is completely true. So there's really no point in me comparing so much of Cronus to Nostalrius, so I think that's fair. Like, it's really not a lot of interest, maybe, or benefit to me constantly comparing Nostalrius and Cronus. I think I will try to limit my comparisons when possible. Bear is getting beaten up a little bit, but I think he's going to be okay if I put a shield on him. Torturing poker. That's cool. It's a hot poker rod. Well, never mind that fight. Yeah, okay. That was tough. We pulled 3 mobs, but it... didn't seem to go super well for us. Like, I think they had to use a lay on hands there. We do have 2 paladins. One of them's a tank, but, like, I think between all these paladins, we should be able to also have some backup healing. Like, I know I need to be the main healer, which I'm doing the best I can, considering I'm not heal spec, which they don't know that, and they haven't asked either, so I'm sure they'll find that out if they happen to watch this video, so sorry, guys. But, yeah, so there's one of those Voral Senguts, one of the captured, kind of tortured people. Are we gonna skip him, or what are we doing? Or skipping this side? We should really clear. Oh, don't attack that guy. I think that guy is bugged. You're you are stuck in combat now. Yeah, if you attack this guy, you're stuck in combat. It doesn't really work very well to attack him, honestly. Let's throw a renew on this guy there, and keep some heal spammed on Astraea. I didn't mean to cast a second renew, but that's okay. I'm gonna do one more flash heal after this, and then do some wanding for a moment. I mean justice. Oh, I see. We cast a seal of justice. Oh yeah, this is, so this suffering victim, you might have saw it, it like came off this torture rack over here and swung itself at us, so that was kind of interesting looking. It was on this thing here. I guess we're skipping that pull? Okay, that's fine. Did Asriel just die? I was like, oh, why did our guy just die? Let's target the 31st, and we'll mark this guy. Judge the enemy justice. I don't know what he's saying. Like, I don't understand. I don't know paladin skills at all. Like, I don't know anything on paladin skills. I don't play paladins, so... yeah, I'm not sure exactly. Okay, so let's put a dot on that one. And we tried to... Oh, we did get a freezing trap. Good job. Good job, team. Let's renew flash heal. Oh, the hunter did a good crowd control and freezing trapped that guy. But then he did like a multi-shot, I guess, and hit the freezing trap guy and broke him out of the trap. So, a little unnecessary. I don't know much about hunters either. I've honestly never played a hunter. I've never played a paladin, so I don't really know very, I know very little about them. Let's see, there should be some rare spawns. Usually there's at least one or two rare spawns here. Plenty rare spawn on the right up ahead, a few pulls. As Sheer the Sleepless is a rare spawn. I think there's only one rare spawn at a time. The other one here would be Iron Spine, which I don't think you can have more than one rare spawn at a time. I'm pretty sure it's just one at a time. Let's keep our warrior healed up, but I'm going to kind of look around a little while we're doing this. Everyone seems to be doing okay. And we can wand a little. These are non-elites, by the way, these pulls. These are just these little blue spirits. They're non-elites. Nothing really need to worry about. I do have... Okay. So we're also looking for... What is it? Iron Spine. Slash target Iron Spine. Zone out and back in to clear combat bug. Slash target... Clean everything. What's the other one I'm looking for? Fallen Champion? I think it's guaranteed. What? Why would the bear... Why would you do that? Bear, why? Oh my gosh. Okay, well, I can't fear these things. I'm trying to watch Bear's health down here. And just wanding this guy a little bit. Let's cast a renew on, I guess, everyone. Let's shield up there. Let's cast a quick flash heal. Well, that was good. I mean, I guess that worked. I just don't know why he would pull it, but that's okay. Actually, it was fine. This next one is... the next one is an elite, these Haunting Phantasms. And they're even worse, because they will actually summon other elites, I believe. So they're going to be a little bit gross. There's also a solid chest over here. That solid chest is actually pretty easy to get a hold of. It's only one mob that you have to pull to get to it. Man, the bear, Veer the Bear, is tanking really well. Like, really, really well. I mean, like, I'm not even healing this thing. It's just solid. Solid bear. I think our group should be coming back now. I think they zoned in and out, so they should be ready to go. Although I feel kind of bad taking stuff for them. Let's keep going, though. Let's pull. So... There's a chest over here, and only one mob to kill for it. I want to mark that so people know what I'm talking about. Oh, I got a black guy on this guy. Cool. Let's see. Ooh, our hunter, is taking some damage. I'm going to give him a heal. No quest for SM Graveyard for Alliance. Yep, no quest over here. Sorry, guys. Guys, wanna get this one chest? Only one pull. No? Maybe? I mean, it's a chest, right? It's not that useful, but... What is that curse? I can't... Can I decurse? I can't. I can cure disease, all. Need to decurse. Can't really do much for this guy if he's cursed. Really, like, seriously, not a lot I can do. I really can't do anything. Like, yeah, that doesn't work. So do we have a decurse or not? Priests can't decurse, right? I'm not, like, making that up. It is minus 75% heal. I was spamming heal. So let's res our friend. Oh, I guess maybe we're getting a res already. Looks like it. Oh, yeah, I'm in combat. Okay. I'm stuck in combat now. Gonna zone out real fast. Yeah, I'm stuck in combat, so I need to zone out real fast. I don't know what else to do. I don't even know how I got stuck in combat. Maybe someone else was stuck in combat first. Let's see, which way do I need to go? I guess you could Alt F4 to get in and out, but I think just zoning in and out works fine. I guess I need powered fort. Alt F4 is probably equivalently fast. Like, it's probably about the same speed to do that, but we'll see. Let's zone in and zone out and zone back in. And I think I'm out of combat. Am I regenning? I think I am, right? Yep, good. Hope they didn't kill the rare spawn without me. That'd be kind of sad. We're going to see, though. And I need to also not aggro that group over there. Okay. Didn't aggro them, so I'm good. And back up here. I got some experience. Hopefully they didn't kill that mob. Find out in a moment. Where are they? Hey guys, rare spawn behind you. Also stuff to loot here. I should grab it, I guess. Let's get it. Let's mark them. Who else needs a fort buff? Looks like they're... Our tank needs a fort buff. Let's do that. Toss a heal on there. And we're good to go. Okay. And it's a non-elite behind them. Wait, where are we going? That wasn't exactly... I guess they're still gonna... They want to get this one now? Okay, cool. I wanted to do this, but no one seemed interested at first, but... Good. Grab that chest, too. I mean, it's one thing, like, to me, chests are so easy to grab. Honestly, how do we deal with a minus 75% heal curse? It's pretty sick. Pretty sick. Grabbing the chest. Let's see what green we get out of here. Greed. Why are we attack? I don't know. Are we, like, full clearing everything? I don't really understand the purpose of this. So, I guess he was saying earlier for XP, but, like, you don't really get a lot of experience in a group in instancing. Like, it just... You do, but it's not a lot. So, to me, it's kind of a waste. Like, it's more efficient to level solo than it is to do this, in my opinion. Than to just, like, pull unnecessary mobs. Like, I don't really see the purpose of it. Let's go ahead and dot that guy. Let's fade, because it seemed like for a moment there we were generating some aggro. I threw a renew on before the fight started, which is generally not a good thing to do, because it will cause you to pull aggro right away, because you're already healing someone if they're not full health. But it worked out, obviously. Okay, ooh, look at that. 9 stamina, 4 spirit. I'm going to need on that. Yeah, I am. I think everyone can need on this, right? I mean, is that like... rude of me to need on it? Everyone need on it? Okay, I'm down for that then. Sick. 9 stamina, 4 spirit. That's, I mean, like, honestly, yeah, I lose 2 spirit, but... Thanks. But that's a lot of stamina. Like, 80 health, that's a lot at this point. So I'm happy to grab that. And I think I will pass on the next thing that drops up ahead. I feel bad if I get 2 things at this point. Alright, we're gonna go ahead, guys. We good? Careful around the corner down here. Mob right there. There's a mob, like, right around the corner down here. And it's really easy to pull it as soon as you turn the corner. And if you run down there even farther, you'll pull more mobs. And that's really scary. So you want to be careful not to rush this corner. Especially, like, you go on this corner, you're going to pull this phantasm. That's one thing. And then he's going to summon this illusionary phant... What is this thing? Illusionary phantasm. And we also pulled something else back there. I guess I should be healing someone? I don't know. I haven't been healing anyone. Let's shield our buddy up there, but I'm not sure I can do much for him. Besides that, yeah, he's dead. He had a curse on him, and it wasn't going to be much of a heal if I do anything on him. Let's heal this guy. I don't know how we pulled this thing from behind. Like, I'm not, it was like a butt pull, I guess. It's kind of bad. Definitely bad. But at least this is the last mob, I think, when we're about clear. We should be good. Let's get a res on our warlock friend here that blew up. Green on this. Oh, I won the tunic also, which I don't... It's a leather, right? Yeah, we can't even use it anyway. Okay, rezzed. Everyone's good. Let's, powered fort. He's good on everyone except for our dead guy here. He needs a fort. And otherwise, we're fine. So let's go ahead and drink. Okay. Down in that room are mobs on each side. Just pull one side at a time. Oh, no. Well, there goes both sides. Or that. Yep, he's dead. I just can't... I don't think there's any way to heal through this. I'm just going to spam heals best I can. Maybe using like a big heal would be a little bit better here. I don't know. Oh, wait, good. The curse has dropped. That's perfect. I don't know how long that curse lasts. Seemed like it was either really short there or someone decursed it. Cool. And our friend here is getting knocked around quite a lot. Let's try and get a flash heal off in time. I need to fade to get some aggro off of me. Keep the warlock up. I've got a potion I can use if I need to, but I think we're doing okay. Alright, everyone seems okay at the moment. These are non-elites, I guess, and that's it. Good. Okay. Survived that pull. That pull's tough, too, because so as soon as you run down here, there's mobs on left, the left and right. So, I'll show you now that we're down here. In the back distance of the room, which is the left side of the room, there's a mob there, and on this side there's a mob here. You don't need to clear both sides, you can go down either side of this path. I usually go down to the right side, I guess it would be. Go down here, and there's the small pack to pull, and there's about one more trash play you have to do, and you can pull the boss. The boss is pretty much underneath us right now. So if you can pull him, actually, back up here and fight him, and avoid some trash that way. Okay, let's get some targets marked so we can at least get the first target marked so we know what we're doing. Okay, let's pull this way. Oh no, let's go this way. Come on, guys. Nope, that works too. That works too. Let's just do that. That's fine. It really doesn't matter, honestly. Either way is fine. I just have a habit of going this way, I guess. And someone got aggro in the back lines, but I think they're fine. And good, okay. Well, now that we've cleared this side, started to clear this side, might as well keep going down here. Okay, let's take out the big guy if we're gonna do this. Ready when you are, go ahead and pull. Okay, I'm talking to myself here, obviously. They can't hear me, by the way. If I'm talking to them, it's just me talking to myself. Let's go ahead and get a big heal casting on our... I keep saying warrior, but I guess just our tank. Estrella's paladin. Honestly, this is the first paladin tank I've had since I think I ran Dead Mines with a paladin tank once, but that might have even not been on this server. I don't even recall exactly. Oh, I got spirit tap. Good. We're all powered forwarded up. Okay, good. There's a mob like right around the corner here. Okay. There's just this guy there. And then after this, we can just pull the boss who's down here, Blood Mage Thalnos. If someone's good with pulling him, we can get him. I'm gonna dot this guy. Or we can clear the other corner room over there to be safe, which is probably... That's totally fine. I think it's a great idea. And if you notice, it's about 20 minutes into the instance, and we're literally at the boss, like one pull away from the boss. So we... It really is a fast instance. It really is a fast instance, though. Let's see. And there's only two bosses. There's always I think a rare spawn always appears. And then there's a final boss. That's basically it. So, I guess I want to fade there. And let's cast some flash heals on our big guy here. Whoops, I don't mean to do that. Let's shield him. Flash heal. And a big heal. And I think we're doing okay. Whoops, I'm hitting the wrong key. Crap. I just realized I was hitting the wrong key. I meant to hit heal, and I realized I was spamming renew for some reason. That was unfortunate. Let me drink, then boss time. Yeah, that was really stupid. I like moved my hand and set it back on the keyboard and realized too late almost that I was on the wrong key. So that was stupid. All right, where is everyone at? Are we missing 1, 2, 3? Oh, everyone's sitting and drinking. That's why I was like, where? It seemed like we were short people, but now I got it. Okay, we're all pretty much ready to go, I think. Little low on mana and stuff, but we're fine. Let's toss a heal on our warlock there. I'm gonna loot whatever's up here. Okay, and the Blood Mage Thalnos is directly down there. There we go, we got him selected. Okay, let's put a little skull on him so people know what's going on. Our warriors, our tank's moving in. Let's put an inner fire on myself, because I like having that red in case to somehow get aggro. And let's dot. Okay, we got our one dot, and that's all we're gonna do. I'm not really worried about anything else. And just wanding a little bit. I think Bear took aggro for... I think Bear does have aggro. Bear is like a mean tank here. No one's getting aggro off of Bear. Beer the Bear. Yeah, gave Bear a heal. Actually, I think Bear tanks better, like, is more durable. Not a better tank, but more durable than Estrella happens to be. So I did loot. So this is a really nice offhand, but honestly, it's not that much better than what I have. And I can't use it anyway for 2 levels. Since I'm Shadow anyway, it's... I mean, If everyone passes, I'd like to need on that. But if you want it... Goladam, go for it. I mean, if he wants it and it's an upgrade, then he should take it. But otherwise, I'm going to need on it. Or Goladam already... Gulp. Just want to see if he wants it, because if he wants it... need it if you need it. It's only... That's fine, take it. I mean, honestly, it's just... It's a small upgrade for me. I mean, really, it's like +2 to shadow damage. It'd be nice for healing, but I can't use it anyway for a couple levels. So... I don't really, you know, I feel like it's not necessary for me to take it. I already got a nice necklace, which maybe isn't a great priest necklace. Honestly, it's a really good tank necklace. It truly is. 9 stamina, 4 spirit. We didn't even have, like, a warrior in the group. You know, we had paladins, which I'm assuming will spend at least some of their time as healers rather than tanks. So it's not like it was a dedicated tank that I took it from. So I don't feel too bad. And everyone needed on it. So that also helped my motivation. I wasn't going to need on it if only the tank needed on it. But since everyone did, yeah. Let's see. Yeah, unfortunately, I'm not gonna have time to run library right now, which is kind of a bummer. I would like to run it, but I just don't have time. I also need to get a quest for it anyway, so either way, I'll have to run it again if I want to get all the quests done. Sorry, guys. Let me check in guild for a replacement. Since you can summon, it won't be hard. Need one healer for SM library, we can summon. Yeah, and I'll just bail out then, and I can hearth out even. Az also needs to leave, so that's a DPS. So one DPS, one healer. Are we gonna go for this pull here? What's going on? Are we doing this now? Let's kill that thing. Okay, I guess we're going for it. Let's dot that, and let's... Fear as much as we can. Let's throw a shield on our tank, put a renew down, and some big heals. Hopefully it will land quickly. Ooh, the 4 immolates are nasty. Really, those are a lot of immolate damages on there. Our warlock's about to die. I'm trying to keep the warlock up if I can. Let's heal the tank, because the tank has to stay alive. The tank dies is a much worse scenario than anything else. My mana's low. Are we actually killing any mobs? I don't really know what's going on. Let's go ahead and pop a mana potion. We just lost our Wait, the hunter just bailed on us? That's bad. That's really bad. Let's do this. Let's fear all three of them if I can. And let's kill the Scarlet Torturer if possible over here. Let's kill this one if possible over here. Let's try to keep the warrior up. Oh no, the warrior's dead. I guess the warrior's alive, but I'm like out of mana almost. Okay. Slash invite math twitch. Okay, let's see. Can I do some more heals? I do have a little bit of mana left, just barely. Okay, well, we did manage to pull it off considering we lost our hunter. So do you guys want to find a healer slash DPS to continue without me? Great, well, we got the chest, I guess. Let's see what's in the chest. You are in a group. Oh wait, there's a suffering victim over there, I think. Okay, we can take care of that. Let's wind on this rat. This guy's dead. Let me... Oh, we got a res already going? Oh, I can res him. Res incoming on Gulladam. Yeah, that's what I just said. But Gull can summon. Alright, suffering victim over here. This thing's kind of fun. Let's invite Math Witch. See, it's kind of funny, this glitch. This thing is so goofy looking. It just like slides across the floor, and I think it's hilarious. Hello. Okay, got a healer. You need a DPS now. Good. So these glimmering pauldrons, let's just greed on them. We don't need them for anything else. And that guy dropped some copper for us. Cool. Okay, I gotta run, but good luck finding a DPS. Alright, you are replacing me, Math. Just want Math to know what's going on. A level 40 can definitely heal, by the way. A level 40 priest gonna destroy a library. So I'm gonna leave out of here and hearth out. So that's a pretty good run for me. I mean, that's a really nice neck. I don't necessarily need stamina as a priest, but it does come with some spirit, which is always handy, but mostly 9 stamina is pretty solid. I mean, I'm happy with that. Okay, good. Well, that worked out really well. Let's see, what do we need to disenchant here? We can disenchant this tunic, and we can disenchant our glowing green talisman. That's junk. And this emblazoned belt. That is also junk. So we can get rid of all those things and vendor a couple small things here. Someone recommended to me that I had some pants down here I was holding on to just to use to just cast enchants on. But there's no enchanting recipes for pants, so I didn't need to keep those anymore, so that was nice. And then let's switch back to our normal leveling gear. Okay, so that's all for today. We managed to get a fair amount done. We hit level 31, got mostly all of our quests for Gnomeregan, and we did Scarlet Monastery Graveyard. So next time, I think we're going to run Gnomeregan, which I'm excited for. It's one of my favorite instances. It's a little bit long, but I think we're going to have a good time, so... That's all for today. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time. Alright, we're gonna see what we can do here. Huh. Yeah, I think we can do this.